In this video, we will discuss about hypopyon corneal ulcer. Hypopyon, which means hypo means below or down, and pyo means pus. It consists of the WBCs, which includes the neutrophils, macrophages, and lymphocytes. In case of an inflammation of this iris, that is the iritis, the blood vessels in the iris and the surrounding ciliary region release these WBCs into the anterior chamber. This is what forms the hypopyon. It can be caused either by bacteria or fungus, and also by the toxins of the bacteria. Common bacteria involved are staph, streptococcus, streptococcus pneumonia, Neisseria gonorrhea, and pseudomonas. Actually, pseudomonas are gram-negative bacilli. And the hypopyon corneal ulcer caused by streptococcus pneumonia is ulcer serpens. Serpens means snake. It is because the corneal ulcer, it slowly goes in a snake-like form. That is, it creeps in. That is, it burrows deep slowly. So that is why it's called as ulcer serpens. And it is normally corneal ulcers are caused in when the pathogen is highly virulent or the person lacks resistance, as in case of old diabetic and alcoholics. So let it this be the Desmond's membrane. Normally the bacteria is not able to penetrate the Desmond's membrane. However, the exceptions are Neisseria gonorrhoeae and Clostridium diphtheria, Cornibacterium diphtheria, which can enter. However, these bacteria produce toxins which can enter into the anterior chamber, and they combine with the WBCs, and this forms the hypopyon, which is a sterile media. So let this be the hypopyon present inside the anterior chamber. In case of bacterial infection, it is fluid in nature and it is rapidly reabsorbed. That is, within 2 hours after curing, it can be reabsorbed. On tilting this, due to fluidity, it resettles and forms a flat line. However, in case of a fungal infection, the fungus can penetrate the cornea and it combines with the WBC. That is, the WBCs adhere into the meshwork of the fungi, and this hypopyon is not fluid and it cannot be reabsorbed. So when the head is tilted, this hypopyon does not flow down and form a horizontal line. It looks like this even after tilting. So normally there is no need to remove this hypopyon, as it gets reabsorbed once the infection goes away. However, in case of resistant fungal infections, that is, even after giving antifungals, there is no effect, then we have to do an tapping and send it for culture and sensitivity. Normally it said the source is chronic dacrocystitis for this bacterial and fungal infections. The symptoms include pain and foreign body sensation when we close the eyes, and watering, photophobia, for which sunglasses can be prescribed to the patient, and redness of the eye. The signs include swelling of the eyelids and chemosed conjunctiva and hyperemic conjunctiva, and we can generally see the ulcer area over the cornea. Clinical examinations to be done. Take a history, check whether he is a known case of chronic dacryocystitis, and do the general examination. And ocular examinations include a normal light examination, regurgitation and or syringing test to check for this chronic dacryocystitis, and slit lamp examination, that is after applying the fluorescent dye you have to check. If you see through the blue filter, we can see that the ulcer areas has green opaque regions. Lab investigations include, you have to scrape the base and the margins of the ulcer using this is a Kimura spatula, and you can also use a bent over bent end of the hypodermic needle, that is a normal syringe. And in case it is a bacteria, we generally do Gram staining, calcofloor stain, 10% KOH solution, potassium hydroxide, and we have to do blood agar and Sabaud dextrose agar culture. Based upon this finding, we can classify whether it is bacteria or fungi. For bacteria, it is a Gram stain will be positive. For fungi, calcofloor stain will be positive. And similarly, the fungal organisms which cause the corneal ulcer are Aspergillus, Fusarium and Candida. So now we'll come into the treatment part. In case of bacteria,